Hey, welcome to our show, guys. It's Goose in the Wild, and we're up here in Mapleton today at a private barn, private jumping arena. And you've probably wondered what our topic is today.
Actually, I wasn't wondering that so much as I was wondering, what's the deal with the pink shirt?
What, you don't like pink, Bryce?
I don't know. What does it say about a guy that wears a pink shirt?
Hey, I've been told that it takes a real man to wear pink. How am I doing?
Yeah, you're a real man, Goose.
Okay. Well, I know we're doing our show with some girls today.
Oh.
So I thought I would be in costume again.
Showing your feminine side.
Showing my feminine
side. I think you can relate to them better.
You bet.
That's scary.
All right. So we're going to introduce you to our first two guests today. Our first guest is Dell Woolsey, and he's the uncle of Steve Woolsey. We did a bull riding show with Steve, so welcome
That's
to our
right.
show. And his good wife, Kathy Woolsey. Welcome to our show.
Thanks.
Boy, it's beautiful up here today, isn't it?
It is. It's a nice place. Yeah, it's nice next to the mountains. It's nice and cool.
Okay, so our topic today is what?
Jumping horses. How to get a jumping horse started. And we're going to go over a little bit about starting them. And then we're going to show you what the finished product looks like once we go indoors.
Beautiful. Now, you're probably wondering, this is our fourth horse show. We thought we'd do a little series because so many people love horses, don't they?
Absolutely.
I remember you telling me before over in Salem that a lot of people will stop there on the main drag and get out of their cars to come over and pet the horses.
Yeah, horses are a draw, definitely.
And why do you think that is?
Because they're big, quiet, lovable creatures.
I love that. Bryce?
Yes, sir.
We're going to head right over to the arena where the girls and horses are. So here we go.
Oh, we march from here to there. Doesn't matter where. We're a little courier.
Now this first gal here, what's her name?
This is Crosby Joyner on Leonella.
Now your famous dad is who?
Wally Joyner.
I thought I'd be in costume today. He played for the California Angels, didn't he?
Yes, he did.
And BYU.
Yes, he did.
And he was a dandy first baseman and a heck of a hitter. Right?
Yes, he was.
Yeah. All right. And your horse's name was what?
Leonella.
What kind of a name is that, George?
Well, I was told by Mike that if it's a girl horse, you give her a girl name. Right?
That's pretty true.
Okay. And if it's a boy horse, which is a colt, right?
Yes.
And what's a girl horse called?
A filly. And they're a baby, that's what they're called.
When they're a baby. All right, and then this is your sister here?
Yes.
All right, what's her name?
I'm Chase Joyner.
Chase Joyner, all right. And who's the oldest?
I am.
By how many years?
20 months.
20 months.
Yep.
Man, that's good. Being that close, do you get along?
Sometimes.
All right. Well, and the name of your horse?
Ryan?
Yep. So it's got to be a male.
Yep.
Hey.
You got this
good.
Thing figured out.
I got it figured out. All right, Dale. So the first thing you do to a horse to get him trained to jump is what?
Well, obviously you get him broke first, and then you start putting him through grids.
Grids.
Which is what we've got right here. We got a little grid set up. Teaches the horse how to lengthen and shorten their stride and move forward and come back. So that being said, we'll go ahead and get Kayla Grohl on Dewey.
Okay, here's the...
She'll be the first down through there. Old Dewey's a pretty good broke old horse. He's been around a long time. So we'll get him to go down through there.
Bryce, can we get Kayla on camera?
Kayla Bird.
Yeah. Kayla Bird.
Hi.
Welcome to our show.
Well, thanks.
Oh, this is the way the ball players do
yeah,
it.
Yeah, that's
all
where
right.
you go.
All right. Okay, we're going to take a look at these gals in action right now, Bryce.
Holy cow, stand back, Goose.
No, it's not holy cow today, it's holy horse.
Holy horse! Ooh. Oh man, that looks fun, doesn't it?
Now if you notice some of those, the first one, it's up about a foot, maybe a foot and a half, and then they go to these two lower ones.
Like you could jump those lower ones.
Oh,
there.
I could jump them.
But I don't think
ones.
You get that first one. See, no problem.
All right. Now we're gonna ask Dell here in just a minute why they go from high to low. And then no boards at the end. Uh-oh. Okay, the horse hit that one, Bryce. Did you hear that?
Yeah. No score. That's a no time.
Well, that's a no time.
I don't know. What'd you think of that?
Well, I think it's pretty good. I mean, it's kind of like when we did long jump with the kids. We started them short.
Yeah.
And then we moved them out after we got them warmed up. And I imagine that these girls...
Oh, we missed one there. Look at that. They're up there. How high is that?
Now, how high are we here, Dale?
Oh, we're only about 18 inches right there.
18 inches. Now, I want to ask you this question, Dale. How come we start with the boards cross?
That's a cross rail. Makes it easy for the horse to get up and over it. Just relaxes them a little bit. Gets them ready for the rest of the work.
Okay, and then these two, you had them right on the ground at low height. Why is that?
Just because we're warming them up. We want them to come through without having to work real hard the first one or two times through. Then we start building them as we go.
Oh, my gosh.
Okay, well, just like we do our PE students and our athletes, we've got to get them warmed up and stretched,
absolutely,
right?
And these guys are quite good at it. Good job, Todd.
How long does it typically take to train a good jumper?
Usually you start a horse jumping when they're four. Some people start them at three. We like to start them at four. And truly a horse is never completely trained. We're training right up through their entire life. Ryan horse is nine. How old's Dewey?
11.
Is 11. Dewey's the biggest jumper here. And Leonella is 7 or 8?
8.
8. I like that. See that? She's a multitask gal. She can do more than one things at a time. You notice that? She was jumping and telling us how old the horse was. That's pretty good, isn't it, Bryce?
It's pretty good. Give her a cell phone, see if she can talk and jump at the same
time.
I'll
bet she can.
She will.
Can you talk on a cell phone and jump at the same time?
Probably.
Okay. There's the cell.
Oh, look at this. We're adding more to it already, Goose.
Okay, Dale. I usually give my PE students a 12-minute warm-up every day to get them in shape and get them warmed up. How long is a typical horse warm-up?
Usually these guys will warm up for 15 or 20 minutes on the flat, which is without fences, just suppling, getting your horse listening to you. And when we come down through here just a couple times, because the muscles are already warm, the horse is listening first, because we've already done that on the flat, right? So
right.
Now they're ready to jump. And we'll just keep building them up. If the horse lacks confidence coming through here, we'll back off, let him come through a few more times until he gets his confidence and smooth.
Beautiful. You know what a part I like about that, guys?
What part?
The part about listening. I had kids in my class. I had gang bangers and wannabe bangers in there. They didn't want to listen to me because you know why? They have their own rules. They're not going to listen to me or any other teacher in the building or any administrator. So I love that term, listen. Even in the horse world, you got to be a good listener.
Or else what?
If they're not a good listener, Dale, then what?
Then they'll wreck. They'll knock rails, which in the show is a penalty point. So you don't want your horse hitting rails. But if they're really not listening, we jump the big octers like we're going to do inside.
Okay.
The horse will fall down.
Oh.
The rider will come off.
And so he could get injured.
Absolutely.
All right.
It happens every day.
Every day.
So that's why we practice.
Beautiful. Oh, I love that. Okay, guys. Oh, it's beautiful up here, Bryce. Beautiful day. Beautiful. Hey, we're going to be back in just a minute. We're going to see if these horses can actually jump these higher rails. We'll be back in just a minute. All right, let's see if these gals can jump these higher rails. What do you think, Dale?
They got her.
They got her?
That's because we prepared for it.
Oh, preparation, baby. Let's see.
I don't know, Goose. They got to jump three in a row. And that last one, how high is that last one?
Oh, that's just 3 feet.
Oh, just 3 feet.
All right, here's the cross.
Oh!
Made it look easy. Remind me of old Ralph Boston back in the 60s. He used to have the long jump world record.
All right.
Ralph Boston. The guy could flat out jump. Oh, the dirt came.
something different here.
Dale?
Yeah.
We got a double here now.
This is an oxer.
What does that mean?
It makes the horse jump across it. So they have to use themselves a little bit differently. A vertical, horse jumps up and over. An oxer, a horse will jump across a little more to make the span.
Now, is that spelled O-X-E-R?
Yeah.
Oxer. Where do you think that term came from?
Having a clue.
Having a clue.
Jumping oxen.
Do you think that's it?
No.
Okay. Right.
It's probably a European word of some sort.
You're probably right. European. Probably a European term, and I know Bryce will look it up and he'll spell it on the screen for us. O-X-E-R. Right, Bryce?
You got it.
Nod the camera.
Okay, I'll do that.
Beautiful. All right.
All right, Goose, let's try this. Let's see if a goose can do this. Horse can do it. Can a goose do it?
Well, a goose can do it. Right, Kathy?
Let's go. What do you think, Kathy?
I think you can, Goose.
All right, let's try it.
Yeah.
Four in a row. Here we go.
All right, here we go, buddy.
And we're off.
Oh, here's
this
the third one.
Stretch. Yeah, baby. Well, if a goose can do it, a horse should be able to do it.
Yeah.
What score would you give her?
How do we rate them, Dale? How do we score them?
Well, she would be scored clean because she went clean.
Look out, Goose, look out. Hey, we got an example here.
4 points.
Okay, so we don't give them a number score?
No, they get a time allowed within a time frame and rails left up. Every rail is a penalty point, 4 penalty points to be exact.
I want to know, Dale, how they feel after the last jump. You used a term called buck and play. What does that mean?
Okay, the Ryan horse, he's more of a free spirit. So when he jumps his last fence, he likes to put his head down and waller around and buck a little bit, okay? Ultimately, we don't want him doing that on course, but because of the way this horse is and the way he goes and his attitude, we let him play a little bit because if we rob him of his spirit, he'll be less likely to jump huge, big fences later on. So we'll let you watch him play a little bit. And he might not do it, but usually he plays a little after the oxer.
You know what that reminds me of, Bryce?
What?
These football players after they score a TD.
Yeah,
and they're showing off.
Absolutely.
And the old Terrell Owens, he's big for that. Take a pen out and sign the football and all this. Is that?
That's Ryan, right?
That's
there.
Ryan, baby. He's a Terrell Owens of the horse world, baby.
Are they all real good for the camera? Find out. We'll find out.
Look at this. Look at him.
That's the T.O. of the horse world, baby.
Little showtime.
That's pretty good there.
That was pretty good.
Okay, she's just going to come to the cross rail, canter one stride, two stride, over the ox. Good job.
See, now this horse didn't show off.
No, she didn't. She's a little quieter, calmer horse.
Love it.
Yep.
Now, what does canter mean?
That's a lope. In the Western world, the canter would just be a lope. It's just a collected round through the back to the bridle canter.
I remember the old time singer from the 40s, old Eddie Canter. Different canter?
Different canter, absolutely. Okay. He can't jump like this.
Okay, baby. I love it.
I think Goose went in here somewhere. Sir, do you know where Goose? Oh.
Hey, we're right here, man.
Wait, you look different.
That's right, little wardrobe change.
Wow.
Okay, give variety to the show.
I feel better about that shirt.
Do you?
Yeah, it's not pink.
Oh, it's more manly?
Yeah.
Good. All right. Guys, we're going to go indoors here now.
Oh, check this out. Cool.
Kathy?
Yeah?
Come on the show here. Since okay. Dale's way out there.
Yeah.
Okay, we've just left the outdoor arena.
Uh-huh.
Okay, what are the horses going to do now?
Well, we just set up some jumps a little higher, and Dale's going to have them do a course. He's going to put a bunch of these higher fences together, like when they go into competition, they have certain fences that are numbered, and they have to jump those fences in order of their number, and then they're judged on speed and the fences being left up. So we're going to do a couple little courses, put some different options available.
Okay, so people are always wondering about cost.
Cost, yeah.
In a general area, what would these three horses cost?
If you bought them?
Uh-huh.
Dewey is...
Which one's Dewey?
Dewey is the one right here that Kayla's on, and he's an eventer. Kayla shows him at prelim and intermediate level, which is really high 4-foot jumps cross country. So they do one phase, which is dressage, and that's where they ride their horse in a pattern in a dressage arena. The next stage is stadium jumping, which is like what we're doing right now with the pretty fences that fell down.
All right.
The last phase is called cross country, and this is what Dale loves the best. And that's where they jump the set fences where you go through the water, over the big hedges, the big permanent logs.
Oh, I was going to ask you about where's the water, Dale?
Yeah.
Where's the water?
So all these horses right here, their prices range from $30,000 up.
$30,000
up. Yeah, these are some really nice horses. They're going in the upper levels. They're worth a lot of money.
So if a horse gets injured, like you said, in here and falls down, then the owner's out some big time cash.
Right, they are. But worse than that, the horse is out a job. Of course, sometimes the horse is pretty happy about it because they get to go out on grass the rest of their life. So.
I'm going to say, is it still the old adage that if a horse hurts a leg, he's got to be shot?
No, not in this world.
Oh, beautiful.
We find homes for them, pastures, put them on pasture, and let them live out their years.
Oh, that's good to hear, isn't it, Bryce?
Absolutely.
They don't have to be euthanized?
Nope.
We try not to.
Yeah, if the horse is going to be in pain his whole life, then we will do that. But we do everything possible not to have that happen.
Oh, that's good.
That's why we practice.
Beautiful.
Condition, boot, get everything right.
I wonder if it's the same in the goose world. What if a goose breaks a wing?
He goes down.
No, he don't.
I'm just kidding, man.
Remember Patty? The rehab, the Raptors and that?
You go to rehab.
Rehab.
Yeah, okay.
See? Yeah. All right.
Okay, we're going to have Cross show you her little course. And
That's short for Crosby, right?
Oh, yeah, Crosby.
I like that. Nickname. Yeah. We're good.
And... this is a little 3-foot course, which is real good for her horse and her level. And then we'll raise the fences and have Chase go, and then we'll raise them again and have Dewey go.
Wow.
Which is Kayla.
Bryce, we always have one or two that don't like to be on camera.
Who is it this time?
Let's get Chris right.
Hello, Chris.
Hey, everybody.
And you're whose hubby?
I'm Kayla over there on that big dark bay.
Are you concerned about her?
No, she's a pretty good rider. She's been doing this for a long time, and Dewey's a good horse, so we trust him.
So you don't worry about the horse throwing your wife?
Right.
Okay.
Some of these guys you worry about, though.
I know. That's right. Especially professional athletes.
Yeah.
Okay. So we got who here, Dale?
Cross.
Oh, this is Cross. All right.
Just a sec.
I thought she's not really listening to me.
Okay. Well, go ahead, canter around, lengthen. Shorten and go. Okay, Cross says Leonella's not listening very well.
Oh.
So we're gonna have her lengthen in the canter, shorten the canter, get her listening a little bit before we go.
Now, in the old days, they used to do some physical attention getting. Do you do physical?
No, behind closed doors. No, not at all.
That's what a riding crop is for, right?
That's right.
Oh, is that what the crop's for?
Yes, and she's carrying a stick, and she will use it if she needs to.
Ooh, that sounds like Teddy Roosevelt. Carry a big stick?
Here we go.
Yeah, but you don't speak softly, Goose.
Oh.
Good, Crosby. She's going to come up this way.
Boy, stand back. Here it comes.
Listen to it. Why is the horse snorting now, Dale?
That's how she breathes.
Oh. Can you guys hear the horse breathing? Snorting?
Sounds like your old 64 Chev when it's first starting up in the morning.
I didn't drive Chevs. I drive Ford. You know that. I don't drive Chevy.
I thought you drove a Chev at BYU.
No, I'm not BYU. Weber State. Driving Ford.
Good job, Cross.
It's a
it's already here.
Did you hear Chris? Brian, he said sorry to hear
he's
that.
He's trash talking you a little bit.
I know, he's trash talking.
Well, he represents most of my viewing audience.
Oh, BYU?
Yeah.
Is that right, Chris?
Yeah, that's right.
All right, you turkey. We got a BYU fan here today.
Everyone in your audience that thinks that's the right way to be, nod your head.
You got to be kidding me. How many Ute fans we got out there? Oh, we got a lot. Don't we, Chris?
Look. I don't think so.
Look at him. All right, guys, we're going to go over here and watch the gals do some jumping, but we've noticed that Dell has raised it a notch.
Two notches.
What? How many notches?
Two.
Two?
Two? Is that right, Dell?
That's right. We got T.O., remember, right here in this horse's body.
This is T.O.? Well, guess what, guys? I'm going to pump him up a little bit. T.O., I'll bet you can't jump this.
The horse whisperer.
I'll bet you can't jump this, pal.
Bet him a bucket of oats.
who we really got here?
We got Orion and Chase.
Oh, okay.
Chase, do you think he can jump it?
Yeah.
And will he show off after?
We'll have to see. Not sure.
All right, T.O., you can't jump it. If you get your rhythm down and your timing, you're going to be a pretty successful hill.
Whoa! Cleared it, barely.
Barely. Does that count, Dale, just barely?
Absolutely, that counts.
So it don't matter how many points you win by, one or 100?
Yeah, we got long a backup over here.
As long as the horse
right
clears.
Behind you.
Oh, all
right. Okay, right here.
Ooh.
Ooh. And you can brush them?
Absolutely.
All right.
Just can't knock them down.
Gotcha.
Here's a tough one here. Yeah. Oh, that was beautiful.
Good job, Chase. Good job. See, one thing you guys need to understand is the height this horse has to jump this fence is here at the apex of this one and this one. That's how high he's got to jump to get over the oxer.
Oh.
So it's not just this height, it's this height here.
Here we go. Who we got next?
We got Kayla Bird on Dewey. And we're going to raise the fences for her.
What?
Yeah, I know.
You kidding me?
No, we're going to raise them again.
Here?
Absolutely, even that one there.
Oh, my gosh.
You're in for a treat now.
Let's rock and roll.
Well, this is dangerous. I don't know about this.
Is it that dangerous, Dale?
Absolutely. If it's not done correctly, you can get people hurt. That's why that's why the horses are worth what they're worth, and that's why the riders are true athletes who work every day at their sport.
So these girls are not couch potatoes.
Absolutely not.
You know, that's good to hear.
Oh, nice. Wow.
Okay.
Right here.
Okay, out of all the fences that sit up here today, which one is the most difficult?
This one right here.
This one right here.
Coming off a tight three stride to a 3-9 oxer.
3-9
oxer.
That
one first. Oh, here we go. Wow. Easily.
Atta girl. Atta girl.
A knicker.
A knicker. Like a baseball.
That was a big one, too. Wow, that's a perfect ride. That's
yeah. Yeah, with a name like Kayla Bird, how can you help but fly, right?
Bird, baby.
Very nice.
And now that goes, I'm still comfortable.
You want us to hike them up?
Sure.
No way. Yeah. Did she really say that?
She said, sure. let's just show them this outside line, hiked up.
Get Dewey over here.
So, you're going to try to jump higher. Do you think he can?
Well, since his name's Dewey. His name is Dewey.
Dewey or what?
I'll bet he don't. I bet you don't.
Oh.
I bet you can't jump this.
Should we put him in a headlock, Dewey?
Dewey or don't. All right,
Dewey.
Baby. Okay. All right. Okay. Rock and roll.
Let's show him.
100 yards around the course by Willie Make It.
Make It. Illustrated by Buddy Moore.
Oh,
there you go.
Wow, very good.
I'm impressed.
He showed you.
He showed me. That's right. That's all we need, right, Chris?
That's it.
That's a home run.
Yeah. Well, hey, this ought to be a show for everybody, right? Those that like horses and those that like good-looking women.
What do you I think our ratings just went through the roof.
Okay. All right, we're going to take a break right here, and when we come back, we're going to close our show.
Uh-oh.
And you know how we close our show.
I was afraid of that.
That's right, baby. We got another dandy for you.
Can't wait. Hey, Goose, you going to come out and finish the show? He said he wanted to go take a break, but I don't know where he went. I'm done. I don't chase him anymore. So I'll let you guys close the show. Any last words from you guys? This is Dale and Kathy. I sure appreciate you being on the show. Any last words?
Well, we've got one more treat for you.
Oh, you do?
Yeah,
cool.
We got an old horse that's been around a long time.
All right.
He's just getting ready to retire, so this will probably be his last jump for the camera.
All right.
Here we go.
Where is it, out here somewhere?
Yeah, he's over here. There he is.
It doesn't look much like a horse to me.
Horse is something.
It does look old, though. What the heck? What are you doing there, Goose? Whoa!
Horse. Hey, have a great day.
What's the name of your horse?
My name of my horse.
Stick.
My
name.
Who?
Stick.
Oh, I like that. Sticks. I like it. That's Goose and the Sticks. And
Goose and the Sticks.
Trust you, Bryce. Hey, have a great day, guys. Remember, we love you. We truly do. Until we. See you on our next show, and we got a couple of more dandies planned for you. Yes. So we'll catch you later. Bye-bye.